With hits like Man Eater, Hall & Oates became one of the most successful duos of all time.
Well, John Oates shares his story, all the ups and downs, and his memoir, Changes Seasons. It's in stores tomorrow, and John joins us from New York. John, we've been talking about your stash, saying he got rid of it. Natalie and I see a little growth coming back. Are we bringing it back?
We got the modern, with the new and improved modern version.
Ah, it's like the goatee stash.
I like it.
Well, you know.
Yeah. Now, this is the heyday. We're seeing the picture of you back in the day.
That's the heavy, heavy early 70s stash.
This is your first photo shoot together, I believe. At least that's what you say in the book. So
it's kind of scary, huh?
Yeah, but talk to me. 50 years together this year. 50 years of great music and tunes that we all still listen to and sing along to every time we hear it. What is your relationship with Daryl like these days?
It's like a brother. It's like having a brother. You know, we tour a lot, so we're together a lot, but we don't, you know, necessarily socialize and hang out. But, you know, it's like when we get together, it's as if time stops. We grew up together, basically, since the time we were teenagers. Then we went through so many things, which, you know, of course, is in the book. It's just, you know, we have a great relationship. We've got a great band. We're heading out on the road with Tears for Fears this summer, and it's going to be amazing. And still a lot of fun.
We always hear Hall & Oates, Hall & Oates. Did you ever think Oates & Hall had a nice ring to it?
Well, I always defer to the older guy, you know. The older guy gets first billing, so.
The older guy.
It does have a ring.
Yeah, no, I mean, and reading through the chapters of the book, I mean, you talk about change of seasons and starting out as the young kid from Philadelphia. I mean, did you ever see yourself reaching this level of success?
I have never had a master plan or a long-term goal. It really was all about the music. And hopefully, you know, that's what comes across in the book is that, you know, I kept my eye on the ball in terms of every decision was based on how can I just keep being a musician. It's something I've always wanted to do. It's something I seemed like I was born to do. And so I just said, you know, whatever it takes for me to be a musician at whatever level, you know, I didn't know we were going to be, a huge success and sell millions of records and still be around even in 2017, which is quite incredible just thinking about that. It was just basically for the love of music.
So many great songs. God, when you hear Hall & Oates, I think you forget how many outstanding songs you guys have put out. Let's talk about some of the stories behind them. What's the story behind Man Eater?
Well, everyone assumes that's about a woman. And to be honest with you, it is actually inspired by a woman. I was sitting in a night spot in Greenwich Village back in the 80s, when the 80s were, you know, it was that Wolf of Wall Street era when everyone was just spending money like it was, you know, water. And this gal came in and she was incredibly beautiful and she had the foulest mouth on any human being I'd ever heard. And I kind of looked at her and I went, man, she would chew you up. And I thought to myself, there's something. And Daryl and I got together. We finished up, but it's actually the song. We wrote the lyrics about the city of New York. The Man Eater is New York City, the way that the city itself can chew you up. So it's really about something else, but you know, that's how songwriters work.
I love that. All right, so what about She's Gone, which actually I think is your favorite song?
Well, She's Gone is the song that kind of started it for us. I got stood up on a date on New Year's Eve. I had met a gal. Yeah, I met a gal down in the village in the middle of the night, in the middle of winter. She was wearing a pink tutu and cowboy boots, and we started dating immediately, pretty much. It was the 70s, so you know. I had kind of made a plan to get together on New Year's Eve. She never showed up. So I sat on the couch and went, she's gone, oh, I, kind of this little folk song. Next day, Daryl came in and I played it for him and he said, come on, man, let's make that happen. He sat down at the piano and played this really cool piano riff. We literally wrote that song in about 2 hours.
Wow. Oh my God. Do we ever hear from her again?
I've seen her on occasion. I always thank her.
Oh, I always thank her for tutu came back around.
I thank her for standing me up. It was the best thing that ever happened to me.
So true.
Is she Rich Girl then? What's Rich Girl about?
No, Daryl wrote Rich Girl. It's actually about a guy. There was a guy who was a trust fund kid, and he was a bit irresponsible, let's put it that way. And Daryl came up with the idea, and you know, you can rely on your old man's money and basically change it to Rich Girl because obviously it sounds better.